Okay, well, the most challenging parts that I mostly find in my students are, number one, is the confidence. So I found most of my students, they don't really have enough confidence to talk, do not really have enough confidence to express what they have in mind. And the second is probably writing. Well, mostly when I ask them to write, they will take very long time to finish even a very simple paragraph. Yeah, and then they also have some kind of lack of grammar understanding, lack of vocabulary sometimes. And then mostly when they write, they will literally translate from Bahasa into English. Well, actually, confidence is coming from yourself. Yeah, if you feel free, if you don't have any burden, you probably will feel a lot more confident. But again, if you don't have that, you can always benefit your time. You know, like you can take benefit from your time learning English. For example, if your class, if your company or your school provide you with English lessons, please use your time to speak English all the time in the class. So in that way, you build up your confidence. And also, never skips any lesson, never skips any activities, and then just relax, feel free. Just speak your mind. I think that will be the best solution. Well, I mainly use role play, games, songs, discussion, both in pairs or in groups, and also, we have this no Bahasa policy in all of the classrooms. So we don't tolerate any Bahasa. Yeah, and then we can come up with a funny, not really punishment, you know, like something to make them not to speak Bahasa. And also, yeah, like all of the communications, all of the instruction, everything should be in English.